Hey, what's up guys? This is Vincent, and in this Lightroom Classic tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use collections. Before we start, we need to go over a few housekeeping items. Right now I'm in the library module of Lightroom Classic, and we need to discuss what a Lightroom catalog is. As I mentioned in a previous video, a catalog is a database of your photos, and it points to where the photos are located on your local or external hard drive. In my case, it's on my SD card for demonstration purposes, but you don't want to keep it on the SD card. You want to import the photos into an external or local hard drive. Now, when you first start Lightroom, Lightroom will automatically create a .lrcat file, and that's Lightroom's native file extension for the catalog. And now we go into collections. So what's the difference between a catalog and collection? So a catalog, it's a database of all the photos and where they're located throughout your computer or throughout your photography system or workflow. Whereas a collection, it's similar to folders, but it just breaks down your photos into collections and sub-collections. Think of them as your favorites or grouping your photos into, let's say, anniversary date or wedding event, or just depending on what you're doing with your photos. So if it's for family vacations, you may want to sort some of your photos into which location your vacation was at. It can be redundant depending on how you use folders and how you use collections, but overall, a catalog, it's a broad group of your photos that's not mainly used to organize it. It's just a database. But collections is just a more accurate group or favorites of your photos. And then folders, it's somewhere in between. This catalog automatically creates all sync photographs, quick collection, and then the previous import. I don't sync my photographs to the Creative Cloud. I use a DROPBOX. It is a little bit expensive, but if you're looking for a cheaper alternative, I recommend using pCloud or Sync. I put a link in the description. pCloud does come with a lifetime plan. My photos are already synced on my Dropbox automatically. So all the photos that are on my folder, not these ones on the SD drive, but in my main working Lightroom catalog, they're all synced into a Dropbox. And here you have the previous import, and here we have the quick collection. So a quick collection, as it sounds, it is a collection. Let me make this navigator smaller. And the way a quick collection works is you just pretty much put any of your photos that you want to edit or keep or whatever reason you want to organize them into, you just drag it into this quick collection. You can also press B and it'll automatically select and put the photos in the quick collection. You can also right click on the photos and add them into the quick collection. And with the quick collection, you can save them as a regular collection or you can clear it. Now we're going to get into collections. I'll talk about smart collections in a little bit, but I'm going to create a collection right now just by clicking this plus sign, create collection. I'll label it collection one. And just like folders, you can create collections into sub collections if you want. I'm not going to do that in this case. And then collection one, you can also set it as a target collection. Setting it as a target collection, it just makes this collection one behave like a quick collection. So let me go back to this SD card folder and let me click on this photo. I can drag this photo into the collection, or I can click on another photo and press B, and now it's added into this collection one, but it's not in quick collection. It is a little bit redundant, but you have that option if you want. But the real power of collections, it comes with smart collections. Smart collections allows you to better organize and automatically put folders or put photos in your collection using certain attributes or color labels or star ratings. So let me demonstrate that for you. I'll click on the plus sign, create smart collection. I'll label this smart collection 2. And it's a good idea to keep smart collections in a collection set just because you want to know if there's any type of automatic rules applied to them. you can see here, Smart Collections has a different icon than regular collections. Anyways, Smart Collections, you need to give it some rules. So I'm going to delete these rules. And here's the first rule here. And this rule, make it as pick a flag, and the flag option is flagged, unflagged, or rejected. So I'll keep it at flagged. I'll set another rule, and this is the rating one, or I can pick something else. There's a whole bunch of options you can select, even by date, camera info, and so forth. But this one, for this demonstration, I'll click on label color, and let me go with purple. And you can match any of the rules, or you can match all, or you can match none. So I'll just click on any, click on create, and now here's my smart collection. As you can see, Lightroom automatically has some predefined collections, or smart collections, I should say. But let's take a look at my smart collection that I created. There's nothing in it right now. I'll go to all photographs on this SD card here, and let me label this as purple, and let me go back to smart collection, and as you can see, it's in the smart collection. Now if I go back to this photo, or I can do it here, I can change the label to blue, and now it's removed from my smart collection because it no longer matches the criteria of the smart collection. So I'll go back to my photos again. So you hear it's blue, I'll put it back to purple, and it's in my smart collection again. Another rule I set was the flag. So this one starred, let me remove the star, but it won't matter on what star it is. Let me just flag it, and it should be in this smart collection. If I click on reject on this photo or unflag it, it's removed. So smart collections is pretty intuitive, it's pretty easy to use, and once you get the hang of it, it definitely makes creating and organizing your photos with collections much easier with these color labels and star ratings, as well as the flags. And there's a whole bunch of options, including keywords, camera settings, and so forth. So collections and smart collections, they're a great way to organize your photos beyond using folders and subfolders. If you guys enjoyed this video, give it a like, subscribe, and follow me on Instagram. See you in the next one. Have a good one.